What do you see around you?
Like a street with stones.
I see a street with stones.
And it's, I cannot see the ocean, but I know it's like a boardwalk.
Like a boardwalk next to the ocean. What else do you see around you?
The cafe across the street.
The cafe across the street, okay. Look down at your feet and tell me, what are you wearing?
I can't see myself.
Do you feel that you have a body? Hug yourself and see if you have a body.
No, I don't have a body.
Okay, so do you feel like you're just floating?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go see what's across the street. I want you to float over to that cafe and tell me what you see around you.
I'm sitting.
You're sitting there?
Yes. Round table.
Describe everything to me around you.
I'm having a coffee. I cannot see my face, but my clothes is fancy.
Are you male or female?
Female.
So you say your clothes are fancy. Tell me about your clothes.
Like a skirt. There is somebody who is serving me, so white man, tall. My hair is short.
Your hair is short?
Like with some curl in the side. My hair is blonde.
You have blonde hair, short blonde hair? You said you had a skirt on. How long is your skirt?
It's long. It's puffy.
Long and puffy? What else can you describe from your appearance?
It's a white with a stripe, like white and fuchsia.
White and fuchsia?
Yeah. He just brought the coffee and leave it there.
Are you by yourself or are you with other people?
I am by myself.
How do you feel there sitting by yourself?
Good.
Is this something that you normally do?
Yes.
Tell me about yourself. You said you feel like you're wealthy.
Yes. A little bit arrogant.
You're a little bit arrogant? Tell me about yourself and your family.
I'm smoking.
You're smoking?
Ugh.
No judging. Just tell me what you're doing.
Smoking, have my coffee.
What do you
I'm white.
You're white?
But I have attitude.
You have attitude?
Yeah.
How old do you feel there?
Forties.
In your forties?
Like close to the forties, yes.
Okay. Look around you. Where do you think you are?
It's a restaurant. But I'm sitting in the corner.
Okay. Outside?
Inside.
Inside, okay.
By myself, just looking outside.
What's going on outside?
It's quiet.
It's quiet? Are there any people out there?
there's some people walking by.
Mm-hmm.
Very elegant.
Very elegant. Are they also wearing long dresses?
And the men are wearing like suits.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Are they wearing anything on their head?
No.
Mm-hmm. Are they carrying anything?
The women are having umbrellas.
Mm-hmm. They have a little umbrella.
Yeah.
Is it a cold time or is it warm time outside?
It's not cold.
Okay, good. Now tell me if there's anything else in that scene that's important to focus on.
No.
Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to close that scene. Close it in your mind, and now we're going to go drifting and floating into another time in that same lifetime. Let's go to another important event. I want you to go to your house, the place where you live, and tell me what it looks like.
Mm. Wow.
Describe it for me.
Oh, it has stairs.
Mm-hmm.
They are connected to each other when you walk into the door.
Mm-hmm. What else? What do you mean by connected to each other?
Because they are in each side of the house.
Ah.
With the big chandelier in the middle. Mm. All crystal.
Crystal chandelier.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What else do you see?
I'm little.
You're little? Tell me about that. What does that mean?
I'm small.
Are you a little girl?
Yeah.
Okay. How old do you feel there?
5.
Mm-hmm.
I'm alone in the house.
You are. Let's see what happens. Let's look around the house.
A lot of windows, mm-hmm. Big windows.
Mm-hmm. What's outside of those windows? Can you see?
Beautiful gardens.
Mm-hmm.
I see people in the garden.
Mm-hmm. What are they doing there?
They are like having a tea.
People are having tea in the garden?
Yes.
How many are there?
Looks like my mother with hat, mm-hmm. and friends having tea.
Your mother has a hat?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And how many friends are there?
Two friends,
uh-huh. Is there anyone out there?
They're laughing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking at them in the window.
How do you feel when you're looking at your mother and her friends?
Not good.
Not good? Tell me why.
Why I'm not there.
Mm-hmm. Are you not allowed to go out there?
I'm in the house alone.
Mm-hmm. What emotions are you getting?
Not good.
Tell me about it.
I'm sad.
Mm-hmm.
She's fancy.
She's fancy?
We have people serving tea.
Mm-hmm. What do they look like?
They're wearing aprons.
Mm-hmm. What color are their dresses?
Blue.
Mm.
White apron.
Tell me more.
I'm just looking at them.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder why I cannot be there.
Let's find out why. Let's find out why you can't be there. I want you to close that scene and go to the time when it will tell you why you cannot be there. Go there now. Where are you?
Older.
You're older, okay. How old are you?
15.
15? Mm-hmm. Where are you?
In the garden.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
They still sit in there. They're having tea again.
Your mother and her friends?
Yes.
What are you doing?
Standing there looking at them.
Do they see you?
They're ignoring me.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
My mom keeping them busy, talking.
Mm-hmm. What emotions are you feeling?
Ignore.
You feel ignored?
Like I'm being ignored, yes. Mm-hmm.
Go deep inside of you. What feelings are you feeling there?
I don't care anymore.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
The lady who saw the tea, she always look at me.
Mm-hmm.
She just knock her head and it's like she can understand my mother behavior.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about this woman?
She's nice.
Mm-hmm. Does she take care of you?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let's leave that scene behind and let's go to another scene in that same lifetime when something important is happening. Be there now.
I'm getting married.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about it.
Very handsome man. Tall. Quiet. Blue eyes.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about him?
I'm happy.
Mm-hmm. What's his name?
Chris.
Chris?
Yes, Chris.
Uh-huh, his name is Chris?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you recognize him?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What does he call you?
Eva.
Eva, mm-hmm. So Eva, what happens now at the wedding?
We're sharing, we're celebrating.
We're celebrating, mm-hmm.
He look at me with a lot of love.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
I'm very happy.
Mm-hmm. Who's in the wedding with you? Look around.
I don't see anybody.
Are you alone with Chris?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Where are you getting married?
In the house.
Mm-hmm. There's nobody there?
I don't see anybody.
How does that make you feel?
I don't care.
Mm-hmm. Is this your house?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
My house when I grow up.
Mm-hmm. But nobody else is there?
No.
Let's find out to see where everybody is. I want you to find out where everybody is in your house, why they're not at your wedding. Go to that scene.
It's a party outside.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of catering.
A lot of catering.
Mm-hmm. Yes, very elegant, everything. It has the garden is gorgeous, fantastic.
Tell me more about this place.
We're walking outside. We're talking to everybody. And my mother is sitting with her friends again.
What happens with your mother?
We don't talk.
Do you have a father?
No.
What happened to your father?
I don't see him.
Does all of this belong to your mother?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Where did she get the means to have this place? Is this from her family? Or does she do something important? Where does the money come from?
She's a doctor.
She's a doctor. Mm-hmm. Tell me more. What are you feeling? Where are you?
Talking to Chris.
Mm-hmm. What are you talking about?
He's just been flirting.
He's flirting with you?
Kissing on the face.
Mm-hmm.
We have a champagne in the hand.
You have champagne in your hand?
Mm-hmm. His suit is gray, like silver color.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, silver gray.
Silver gray.
Suit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And what is your wedding dress like?
White.
Mm-hmm.
Very puffy.
Very puffy.
Mm-hmm. Less so.
What are the other women wearing? Are they wearing also long puffy dresses?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Very elegant.
Very elegant. Very good. Do you hear any music playing?
Violin.
Violins. Mm-hmm. What else happens? What happened?
I don't see Chris anymore.
Where is Chris?
I'm alone standing there.
You're standing there by yourself?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where did he go?
I don't know.
But it gives you sadness to see him gone?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's close that scene now. Close the scene and let's go to another important scene in that lifetime. Move forward now.
Standing in the door. He left in the car.
He left in the car?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Chris left. It's an old car.
It's an old car.
Mm-hmm. See? Somebody's driving him.
Somebody's driving him?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And what are you doing?
Standing in the door.
Mm-hmm.
My wedding dress.
So Chris left on your wedding day?
Mm-hmm.
Where did he go?
I don't know.
Let's find out to see where Chris went. Go to the next relevant scene that will tell you where Chris went. Be there now.
We're walking.
Mm-hmm.
And they will walk.
You're walking on the boardwalk?
Mm-hmm.
Who are you with?
Me and Chris.
Mm-hmm.
But the streets are the stone. It looks like in Europe.
It looks like in Europe?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And everything on the other side is restaurant, cafes.
Mm-hmm.
But I cannot see the water, I just see the...
Are there buildings between the water and you?
No. I only see the other side of the street.
Okay. How are you feeling there walking with Chris?
Normal.
Mm-hmm. What's important from the scene?
Not really, nothing.
Mm-hmm. You're just enjoying the walk?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm holding him.
You're holding his hand?
And yes, I have a puffy dress. Big.
Big puffy dress?
Polka dot.
Polka dots?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it puffy? Is it in the back?
In the bottom.
In the bottom.
Like a corset.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm blonde.
You're what?
I have a blonde hair and blue eyes.
Your blonde hair and blue eyes? Mm-hmm.
So do Chris.
You're both blonde and blue-eyed?
Yeah, he's tall, very tall.
Mm-hmm. What do you look like?
Very tall.
You're very tall also?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Skinny.
Tall and skinny. How old do you feel there?
20.
20. Okay. Good. Let's close that scene now and let's move ahead to where you're older and something important has happened. Be there now.
I see somebody in the bed.
Somebody's in the bed? Mm-hmm. Whose bed is this?
I don't know, but it looks like it's in my house in the second floor.
Mm-hmm. Is it a man or a woman?
It's a woman or a lady.
Mm-hmm. Connect with her to see who it is.
It's my mother.
Mm.
She's dying.
How are you feeling?
I have no emotion.
No emotion.
I just can't lay down there.
Mm-hmm. What are you getting from her?
Nothing. I just feel sorry.
You feel sorry for her?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. How old are you now?
30.
Mm-hmm. So what happens next?
I leave her there and I'm leaving.
You're leaving? Mm-hmm. Where do you go?
Just have somebody waiting for me and driving away.
Mm-hmm. Let's see where you go after this. Where do they take you to? Tell me what you see on your way.
Houses.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of houses.
Mm-hmm.
And the street is stone.
The street is what?
Stones.
Stones?
Mm-hmm. And there's people walking and but so fancy.
Everything's fancy?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are the other houses fancy too?
They're made out of the stone.
Out of stone?
Yeah, like a tall, tall houses.
Mm-hmm. Are you in a city?
Yes, I'm in a city.
Mm-hmm. But it's a fancy place.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So let's get to your house and see what it looks like. What do you see? Did you arrive yet?
I just like kind of lost.
You're lost? Mm-hmm.
It's a house. It's weird.
Tell me.
It's very poor, like no furniture, nothing inside.
Mm-hmm.
It's empty.
It's empty?
Mm-hmm.
Is this your house?
I don't know.
Look down at your body and see if you're the same person.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm having a suitcase in my... I've just put it down on the floor.
Mm-hmm.
But the house is empty. And there's no furniture.
What are you doing in that house?
Just standing in the mirror looking around.
Mm-hmm.
There's no window, nothing.
How do you feel in that house?
Not good, I want to leave.
Is this your new house?
Looks like.
Mm-hmm. Are you in a poor place?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So tell me how it is that you became poor.
Chris left.
Chris left? Mm-hmm.
My mother died.
Did you get any of your mother's money?
No, I don't want it.
Mm.
I left.
Is that why Chris left you?
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. Go deep inside of you and you'll know the answer. Tell me what happened.
Yes, he left me.
Mm-hmm. Did you turn your back on your mother and her money?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What was that?
I want nothing from her. She never loved me.
Mm-hmm. So what happens next? Go to the next relevant scene of that lifetime when something important is happening.
I'm getting in a plane.
You're getting in a plane?
Yeah.
How old are you there?
40.
Mm-hmm.
I'm single and beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Getting in.
Where are you?
I arrived in the airport.
Mm-hmm. Where are you?
Yes, some friend who picked me up.
Some friend pick you up from the airport?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Where did you go? Tell me about it.
It's in the car. But I don't see who is. I don't see their faces.
How do you feel in the car with them?
Weird.
You feel weird? Tell me why you feel weird. Do you feel in danger?
It's like dark. It's like no human form. It's like
Are they in the car with you?
Yeah.
Where are they in the car?
One in the back, one in the front.
But you say they have no form.
No, there's like black shadow.
Black shadows. Let's see what happens with those black shadows. Tell me what happens.
I tell the car to stop.
I tell the car to stop.
Because I want to walk alone. I just don't know where I'm walking.
Are you holding anything in your hands?
It's okay.
Look around you. Where are you?
It's a city.
So the car has stopped and you're walking now?
I stopped. I'm looking at the city.
What does the city look like?
It's different.
What is it?
It's different from what I come from.
Different than when you come from? The houses are different?
It's small.
A small place?
Yeah.
Do you see any people walking around?
Yeah.
How are they dressed?
Simple.
Simple clothing? By looking at them, what do you think that these people do for a living?
It's simple, but not that simple. But it's like the women's wear hat. The men too.
What are they wearing?
Hats.
Hats. Okay. Are they simple hats?
Yeah.
Okay. Are their dresses short or long?
The women wear gloves.
They wear gloves.
They wear gloves, yes. Necklace.
Do they look elegant in their simple clothes?
Yeah, they look nice. They're friendly.
They're friendly. So let's see what happens next as you walk with your suitcase. Where do you go?
To a hotel. Elegant.
An elegant hotel?
Yeah.
What is it that you're doing there?
I just arrived.
What's the reason for you going to this place?
I don't have a house.
So you've just gone to a new place?
Yeah.
Okay.
So tell me what happens next. Go to the next relevant scene in that lifetime that explains what it is that you're doing there.
I'm getting married again.
Mm-hmm. Look into his eyes and see if you recognize him.
I can't see it.
Tell me about this wedding. What's it like?
It's in the hotel.
Hmm. Who are you marrying? Hmm.
The owner of the hotel.
Ah. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about him?
He has black hair. Mm-hmm. Tall, white. I like him.
You like him. Good.
He's nice.
Okay. So let me know if there's anything else in that scene that's important.
No.
Okay. So close the scene behind you. And now let's move ahead to where you're older. Go to where you're older now. Something is happening. Where are you?
Very old, alone.
You're alone?
In that hotel.
Mm-hmm. What happened?
I'm very old.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
60.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
I'm sitting in the patio of the hotel alone.
In the patio of the hotel alone? Mm-hmm. Do you feel single or you're married?
Single.
What happened to your husband?
I guess he died.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How do you feel? What emotions are coming up?
Peaceful. I have nothing to worry about.
You have nothing?
Nothing to worry about.
Nothing to worry about. Everything is taken care of.
Yes, I have this big hotel for myself.
Mm-hmm. Does anybody live in that big hotel?
I just see the girl who's in the front.
Mm-hmm.
Who check the people.
Mm-hmm.
And the red flowers. And the entering with drapery is beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good. So close that scene now. Let's go to the last day of your life to see where it is that you are. Move to the last day.
I'm dying.
Mm-hmm. Where are you?
I'm dying alone. Just like my mother.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Who's with you?
Nobody.
Nobody. Are you in the hotel?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What are you dying of?
Old.
You're just old? How old do you feel there?
90.
Mm-hmm.
That's all.
So let's go to the moment before you're taking your last breath, and I want you to tell me what thoughts are going through your mind about your life.
Love.
Love? Tell me about that.
How lucky I am.
That you found a man?
He loved me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm content dying.
Okay, so let's take the last breath, and now you're on the other side of it, and you can look back at that life, that entire life. Every life has a purpose and a lesson. What was the purpose of that life?
To not let nobody to take advantage of me.
Mm-hmm. And so nobody, don't let anybody take advantage of you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And did you fulfill that purpose?
Yes, I find a good man who teach me love.
The man taught you love?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, if you look at that life, what lessons did you learn from your experiences?
To be strong.
To be strong? Mm-hmm.
That you can always find love.
Wonderful. So now, as you leave your body, tell me where it is that you go. Where does your spirit go? Eva, do you go to the light?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Who meets you there?
Chris.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel there?
I'm happy to see him.
Mm-hmm. Is there anybody else there that you meet?
No. I see my mother, but she's still like she's in bed dying.
Mm.
Or...
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
So get close to your mother, now that you're in the light.
Mm-hmm.
And let's find out what contracts you had with your mother. Find out what it is that she was supposed to teach you in that lifetime. Look at her in her real form.
Punishment.
Mm-hmm. Punishment? And what was the reason for that? Did you have a contract with her?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What was the contract?
To not let anybody to take advantage of me.
Mm-hmm. So by being the way she was, she made it difficult for you?
She ignored me.
Mm-hmm. She ignored you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's leave that scene and let's go now to another lifetime where you are with your mother. We're going to find out why it is that you always have a difficult situation with your mother. I want you to leave that scene and go to that lifetime. Tell me where you are.
I'm in the big house with my mother and we are playing.
Mm-hmm.
We're like going around and around.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Is it the same lifetime you just left?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So tell me how your mother feels about you now.
She was happy,
mm-hmm,
playing with me.
So let's find out when that changed. I want you to go to the moment where that changed.
When my father left her,
mm-hmm,
I see him leaving too.
What happened?
He left us.
Mm-hmm.
She became angry.
She became angry? Mm-hmm.
She doesn't want to be near me.
So she took it out on you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And why did she take it out on you? I want you to connect with your mother and feel her thoughts. Think her thoughts and find out what it was.
I never want to have you. I just want to make your father happy.
Mm-hmm. So she wasn't in love with you, she was in love with her father.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And she had you just to make him happy?
Mm-hmm.
So she never loved you?
No.
Can you accept that?
I forgive her.
Okay. Do you understand that it wasn't you, it was her anger
mm-hmm.
all this time against your father?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. So I want you to go back through that entire life. I want you to see that entire life and everything that your mother did. And I want you to just use a magic eraser and just erase all of those feelings that you had, all of that resentment. Wipe everything out. Anytime your mother looked at you and ignored you, wipe it all out. Wipe all of that out. Go backwards in time, wiping out all of those memories. And now when you go back to the day that you were born, go all the way back to the day that you were born. And now we're going to move forward in time again with that knowledge and knowing that you are a happy person, that you are a person who is here to be born to learn lessons, and that your mother is not going to make you feel bad. So let's go through that lifetime again and you see how you go through it without all those feelings until you get to the end of your life. And now you're back at the end of your life, and I want you to go backwards again, erasing all of those resentments and feelings that you had. Go backwards, all the way back to the day you were born, erasing all of those negative feelings. And when you go back to the date of your birth, go forward again, one more time. Now go to the end of your life. And now I want you to do it one more time very quickly. Go back quickly, running through it, backwards, erasing all of that, all those feelings. And now go forward again until the day of your death. And now tell me how you feel.
Feel at peace.
Feel at peace. Very good. Very good. Why did you bring forward that one of this wealthy woman?
To teach her a lesson.
To teach her a lesson.
Yes.
What lesson was that?
Values.
Values. Mm-hmm. What were you telling her about? Explain that to her. Are you comparing it to this life that she's living?
No.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about it.
She loves money.
She loves money. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
She loved money then too.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what are you trying to tell her?
Money is not important.
Mm. Would you tell her what is important?
Love.
Mm-hmm. So tell her more about why you showed her that life.
To learn.
Mm-hmm.
To put love first.
Put love first. Mm-hmm. What about the mother in that situation, in that life? We did a little healing with that time, but what about this lifetime?
Hmm. No good.
No good. From a higher self perspective, what is she learning in this lifetime with her mother?
She's taking all her anger with her.
Mm-hmm. So her mother was born with the same anger from being left in that lifetime?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Where was that lifetime?
1893.
Okay. Was it in Europe?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
British.
British. Mm-hmm. And what kind of family was that?
Hey, wealthy.
Wealthy. Mm-hmm. So what can we do to help her mother today?
Less of forget, less of forget. Forgive. She needs to forget her mother.
She needs to forgive her mother? Okay. Would you allow me to work on that right now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And we'll get back to you in a moment.
All right, so what I'm going to do now is take a deep breath in and come back, and I'm going to put my hand on your chest, and when I do, I want you to give me all of the feelings that you have with your mother, all of the anger, all of the resentment, all of the pain that you have with your mother. Give it all to me. Every time she's hurt you, through this lifetime, any other lifetime that she's lived with you, any other dimension, any other place, I want you to take all of that from every one of those bodies and give them to me. All right, I take it and send it off to the universe. Now in that space that's left, what would you like to put in there?
Love.
Lots of love. Let's put a lot of love there and let's seal it. What else would you like to put in there?
Security.
Security. Let's put security in there. Very good. How does that feel now?
Good.
Good. All right. So in a moment, I'm going to ask to speak with your mother. Take a deep breath in, and when I count from three down to one, let me speak with your mother. Three, two, and one. Be your mother.
Hello?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How are you today?
Okay.
Is this Selena?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Selena, we just watched a past life where you were with your husband in a very wealthy British family. Do you remember that lifetime?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How did that lifetime make you feel?
The way it's supposed to be.
It's not the way it's supposed to be, is it? How did you feel when your husband left you?
In pain.
In pain. Mm-hmm. And what did you do with that pain? Did you keep it inside?
Yes, I suppressed.
Mm-hmm. And what did you do when you saw your daughter?
I took the anger on her.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that was a fair thing to do?
No.
Did you have any? Does she have anything to do with your husband leaving her?
It's her fault.
Why is it her fault?
Because I was not beautiful anymore.
You were not beautiful, and your daughter was?
She changed my body.
Ah, she changed your body. Okay. Well, let me ask you something. Did your daughter physically do this to your body, or did your body do this on its own because you were pregnant?
She did.
She did. You think about it, a baby is the one that changes your body?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So, let me ask you something. Do you have beauty inside of you?
It was more outside.
It was more outside. So you didn't feel beautiful inside?
No.
Okay. Now, if you didn't feel beautiful inside, there's no way that you can feel beautiful outside. Did you know that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So when your daughter was born, when Eva was born, that beauty that you had outside could never be replenished again because there was nothing inside for you to push out anymore, was there? So was it your daughter or you that didn't become beautiful again?
I guess me.
Yeah, you didn't push that beauty out. There was nothing there left. So why would you take it out on your daughter? She was only being born. If you would have loved yourself and loved your daughter, you would have replenished that beauty again. But your body just reacted to your anger and was never able to feel beautiful again. Do you need to hold on to that pain anymore?
No.
Okay. Would you give me that pain and anger?
Yes.
All right. I'm going to put my hand on your chest. Give me all that pain and anger that you felt because your body was not beautiful anymore. Give that all to me. All right, let's take it away. All right, so let me ask you something else. What else did you feel in that lifetime? Why else did you have all that anger towards your daughter?
I have a life with friends.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to entertain them with fancy dinners.
Mm-hmm.
And they was not around many times.
Mm-hmm.
Much often.
And why were you angry?
I like to have a house full of people.
Mm-hmm.
And have a fancy parties.
And what did your daughter have to do with that?
She was difficult.
Mm-hmm. Why do you think she was difficult?
She doesn't behave.
Did she have any friends?
No.
Did she have any brothers and sisters?
No.
So how would you want her to behave if she had nothing else to do? Was it her fault she didn't have friends?
No.
Was it her fault that she didn't have a brother or sister to play with?
No.
Was it her fault that you didn't pay attention to her?
No.
Then why would you be angry at her? Do you realize that you were the one who was punishing her, keeping her from having any friends? Do you realize that she was trying to get your attention?
Yes.
How does that make you feel?
Sad.
Mm-hmm. Would you like to give me that sadness?
Yeah.
You don't need to carry that anymore. Give it to me. Give me that sadness. Knowing that you were angry at your daughter, and at the same time you were the one keeping her from being happy. Give me all of that sadness. And take it away and heal it. What would you like to put instead?
Peace.
Let's put lots of peace in there. Very good. Tell me what else caused you pain in that lifetime.
Just that.
So how do you feel now about your lifetime? Do you feel at peace Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. So now I'd like you to go back to that lifetime, to where you belong. Thank you very much for the time that you've been with us. May the light of the universe accompany you. And now let me speak again with Selene. Selena, how do you feel now?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You feel any better?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How do you feel about your daughter?
I love her.
You love her. Okay. So do you feel that something has been lifted off of you?
Yeah.
All right. Very good. Selena, thank you very much for being with me today. May the light of the universe accompany you. Thank you. Take a deep breath. Let me speak in with your higher self. How is Nelly's feeling now?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Could you answer some questions that she brought here today? What is the purpose of her life? What is she supposed to be doing here?
To pass love.
To pass love around? Mm-hmm. Is she doing it?
She's doing a good job.
Good. That's why she feels happy so much?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. She tells me that she had an experience recently. A session. Can you tell me what that session did to her?
We connect her with God.
Mm-hmm. Connected her with God. So what has caused, what's happened after she's connected with God?
She has a mission.
Okay, what's her mission now?
Heal people.
Heal people, okay. So, in what way can she heal them?
She's very powerful.
Mm-hmm, she is.
Energy. Her energy.
Her energy, mm-hmm. Is that why she's having all of these tremors?
Yes.
Okay, tell me about those tremors, because they're disturbing her and the people around her. Why is she having these tremors?
Her body's not prepared.
It's not prepared for them?
No.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about the tremors. What's going on when she does that?
We choose her.
You chose her?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Her body is not prepared.
Okay. So are you harming her body by sending her these vibrations?
No. We are working on her.
Hmm. Okay. Tell me what it is that you're doing to her body when you send her this energy.
Light.
Light. Mm-hmm.
We're getting light in her body.
What color light?
Gold.
She says that every time she shuts her eyes, she sees that gold light. What does the gold light signify?
She's pure.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
She will see. She will hear. She will prepare people for the new change.
For the new change?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about this new change. Tell me about the new change.
Oh.
take a deep breath in.
We divide into... We are dividing in two.
You're dividing in two? Tell me about that. What does that mean?
The old world and the new one.
The new world and the old world?
Yeah, the old world and the new one.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about this.
2019. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What happens in 2019?
The new earth.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people are awakening. And this is Nelly's mission.
This is Nelly's mission? Tell me what her mission is exactly.
To awaken people.
Mm-hmm. To awaken people.
Uh-huh.
In what way?
To become pure.
Mm-hmm. How is she going to do this mission? How can she become, how can she make them pure?
By passing her energy.
Mm-hmm.
Touching them.
Mm-hmm.
Hear them.
Is she supposed to be a channel?
Yeah. Oh. I want to throw up. Oh. Oh my God, my head is going to explode. Thank you.
You're doing great.
You're very strong. I have to make it do this.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God.
You feel better?
Okay. Yes. I knew that I'm going to throw up.
Oh, so did I. So I was ready for you.
Oh. Wow.
Feel better?
Mm-hmm.
You should. Okay.
Oh.
You ready to do this again? You're much better now, huh?
Yes.
You shouldn't have a headache anymore?
I know. Oh my God. Mm-hmm. I knew it.
Mm-hmm. Feel good? Better?
Mm-hmm.
You should feel much better now. All right, so mm-hmm. let's go with the breath again. I want you to take a deep breath in. And you're going to go deeper now that you feel so much better. Take a deep breath in. And I'm going to start counting from 10 down to 1. Down, 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 and number one, allow me to speak with your higher self.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Thank you. Tell me what happened.
With Nelly's? You sent her power surges?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And her body was not able to take it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What can you do to improve that?
She needs to meditate more.
To meditate more. She seems to be meditating a lot now. How often do you want her to meditate?
An hour.
An hour? Mm-hmm. Or per day?
Yes.
Okay. Good. Would you tell me about her superpowers that you're giving her? You said that she was going to be hearing and seeing. What is she going to do with these powers to help other people?
Going to help
She's going to help? Mm-hmm. In what way?
She's going to... A boy. Terrorist attack.
She's going to avoid terrorist attacks? Mm-hmm. By doing what?
She's going to have the premonitions.
With what?
The premonitions.
Premonitions, okay. So when she has these premonitions, what should she do with them?
She has to say...
Tell people about it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Good. Would you tell Nellie's how many spirit guides she has that are working with her?
Three.
How many?
Three.
Three of them. Do you know their names?
Uriel.
Uriel? Mm-hmm.
Raphael.
Raphael? Mm-hmm.
Michael.
So the three archangels?
Yeah.
Are they here today?
They were always with her.
Do they have anything to tell her today?
Not to worry.
Not to worry. Mm-hmm. Who's her primary guide?
Michael.
Michael. Okay, I want to thank Michael. Tell her about that tremor. What was that all about?
Giving her energy there.
Giving her energy? What's the energy for?
Make her body stronger.
Make her body stronger?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Five dimensions.
Okay.
Yeah.
So by doing these surges that you're giving her, you're preparing her for the fifth dimension?
Yeah.
Okay. In what way?
She needs to become light.
Mm-hmm.
Light.
A light body?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So what exactly are you doing when you're putting these power surges in her?
To protect her.
Mm-hmm. What do you need to protect her from?
Bad energy.
Bad energy. Mm-hmm. Where is this bad energy coming from? Her stomach?
Yes.
What's in her stomach?
Something in there.
Something's in there. Who put that in there?
Selena.
Selena, her mother? When did she put that in there?
When she hit her.
When she hit her. Mm-hmm. Did she do that intentionally? Or was it that... Something
no.
came.
She's anger.
Her anger. Okay.
Yeah, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Would you allow me to help her with this?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So what I'm going to ask is for Archangel Michael, Archangel Uriel, and Archangel Raphael to help with this session right now. I want them in attendance so that they can help me with this energy. I'm going to take my hand and put the energy, bring that energy up, 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 and have you express it. Good evening, brother. How long have you been there with her?
Long time.
Long time. Mm-hmm. Are you male or female?
Female.
Female. Okay, so you're a sister. I'll call you sister. Let me ask you something. What name can I call you?
Eva.
Eva. Okay. Are you the same Eva that we saw?
Yes.
Okay. So this Eva, whose past life we were seeing, was not of Nellie's. It was your past life?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So tell me, Eva, why have you followed Nellie's into this life?
She's a scare.
She's scared. Mm-hmm. How did she attract you to her?
She's insecure.
She's insecure. Mm-hmm. And why did you come to her?
I don't want to leave her.
You don't want to leave her. Did you know her in a different life?
Yeah.
Okay. Who was she in a different life?
Sweet girl.
A sweet girl. Tell me about that. Was she wealthy like you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who was she?
Everybody wants to have what she had.
What did she have?
Beauty and money.
Mm-hmm. And who were you in that life?
Nobody.
Nobody. But you knew her.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Did you have a body in that lifetime?
Yes.
Okay. How did you know her?
I met her in a party.
In a party?
Mm-hmm. In a house.
Mm-hmm. Were you a male or a female in that lifetime?
Female.
Mm-hmm. And what did you like about her?
She sparkled.
She sparkled. Mm-hmm.
Everybody likes her.
Mm-hmm. Now you said that your name was Eva. What was her name in that lifetime?
Eva too.
Oh, she was also Eva. Okay. Mm-hmm. So were you jealous of her?
Yes.
Okay. So tell me more about your life.
I never married.
You never married? Mm-hmm. And then what?
I just want everything that she had.
You wanted everything that she had. So what happened when you died?
I follow her.
Did you become attached to her in that lifetime?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what did you cause her? What symptoms did she feel from you?
Ovary pain.
Ovary pain. Why the ovaries? Why did you choose that?
Because I want the men to use her for sex.
You wanted the men to use her for sex?
Yes.
Because you didn't have any sex.
Yes.
So you were feeling everything that she was feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. So you were using her for pleasure.
Mm-hmm.
For your own pleasure.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you're doing now?
Yeah.
Eva, is that right for you to be using someone else? You used her in that lifetime and you followed her into this one?
Hmm. It's okay with me.
It's okay with you. Is it okay if I ask her if it's okay?
Yeah.
All right. Let me speak with Nellie's. I'm going to tap your forehead. Nellie's, do you hear what's happening with your ovaries?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You have this woman, Eva, who followed you from another life. Mm-hmm. Because she never felt the pleasure of a man. And she was using you. Can you forgive this woman for doing this, not knowing any better?
Yeah.
Would you like to let her go into the light?
Yeah.
All right, thank you. Let me speak with Eva. Eva?
Yes?
Now you have been forgiven for doing this. Are you ready to let go and go into the light so that you can get your own body one day and have that pleasure?
Why?
Because once you have, every soul, once they die, can go into the light and feel the pleasure of love, which you never felt. Love is very different than sex.
It does feel good.
It does feel good, doesn't it? But when you get to the light, it'll even feel even better. Would you like to take a look at the light and see what's there? Take a peek. You don't know what it's like, what you're missing, unless you go there, do you? Take a peek at the light. I want you to come up through her crown, right up through here, and go up into the light. I don't want you to stay there, Eva. That wouldn't be right, because we're not done with you. I want you to go up there and feel what it feels like to be in the light. And report back to me.
That's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. It's different, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Would you like more of that?
Yeah.
All right, come back down here, Eva. You're not ready. Okay, Eva. Before you go, we need to work on you. Would you allow me to help you?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Eva, now that you know how beautiful the light is, there's no reason to stay in her ovaries anymore, isn't it? It's not that beautiful feeling. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Eva, I want you, before you go to the light, to unload all of the feelings that you had in this body. In the body of Eva, in the body of Nelis. I'm going to put my hand on your chest, and I want you to give me all of those feelings that you felt of being someone who was single, who didn't feel beautiful, who had no one to love, no one to have pleasure with. All of that jealousy, all of that anger, all of that pain, all of that resentment that you felt in the lifetime of Eva, and now in the lifetime of Nelis. Give me all of that. You don't need that anymore. Give me all of that. And tell me when it's all out. You ready for me to take it from you?
Mm-hmm.
Good, I'm going to take that and send it up to the universe. Now, Eva, in that place before you go to the light, what would you like to be full of? Lots of love. Let's put lots of love, self-love for yourself and others, and seal it. What else?
Peace.
Let's give you peace. Beautiful. What else? That's it. Do you feel whole and complete?
Yes.
Good. Now, Eva, I want you to pull out from her body every single piece of essence that you have in there. I want you to pull out every cord, every cable, go through her veins, through her cells, through her muscles, through her ligaments, in this body, in the physical body, in the etheric body, in the astral body, in the mental and emotional body. Go through all of her bodies and pull out all of your essence. I want you to go back in time into the life of Eva and pull everything from that lifetime. And pull it in out of this lifetime that Nelis is living right now. Pull everything out like a vacuum cleaner, and I want you to take it with you. I'm asking the angels of the light to come and surround Eva now. Surround her and escort her. I want Eva now to go up through the crown of Nelis' head, and Archangel Michael is there to escort you. Eva, tell me when you get to the light. Very good. Who do you see there?
Chris.
Mm-hmm. Chris is there?
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful. All right. Middle God, the light of the universe accompany you. Thank you very much, Eva. Now I'd like Archangel Raphael to come in and put his wings around this woman's body and all of that light, all of his healing light, from everywhere where Eva resided. Fill her ovaries with that beautiful, beautiful healing light. Fill her entire body with light. And tell me when you're done. Done? Very good. Let me speak with the higher self again. How is she doing?
Good.
She had a question about her eager mind, whether she was getting real confirmation or revelations from her spirit guides. Or was it her mind? Is she getting the real stuff?
Yes.
Okay, good. So stop questioning it?
Yes, she needs to trust.
To trust, okay. Would you do a body scan on her and tell me what you find?
Her head.
What's going on with her head? She says she has brain fog, lack of concentration, and lost memories. What's in her head?
She had a little injury from.
She had a little injury?
Yes.
When was that?
When her mother beat her.
Mm-hmm.
And left her on the floor.
Mm-hmm. How old was she when that happened?
8 years old.
8 years old? Mm-hmm.
Unconscious.
Did she have some brain damage?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What's that causing, that damage?
To forgive everything.
To forget everything?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is this good or bad?
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Because she never remembered.
She doesn't remember.
Any of her past.
Any of her nasty events? Mm-hmm. So was it a gift?
Yeah, we protect her.
Mm-hmm.
Mother Mary is always with her.
Mother Mary, okay.
Yeah, since she was little.
Does Mother Mary have anything to tell her now? Can we speak with Mother Mary today?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mother Mary, what would you like to tell Nellis?
Nellis is a beautiful soul. She suffered a lot.
She suffered a lot. Mm-hmm. What have you done for her?
I rescued her. She has been near death twice.
Twice? Mm-hmm. Is this because of her mother?
One, because her mother.
Mm-hmm.
And the other, an accident.
Another, an accident. And you saved her each time?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more about that, Mother Mary.
I bring her back to her body.
You brought her back to her body?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And her higher self says you've been with her ever since. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I protect her.
What would you like to tell her today?
I protect her. I'm sure this is the worst session you ever have.
No, it's not. You need to throw up more?
No, I'm good. Yes.
Feel better?
Yes, thank you. Okay. Horrible.
Oh. You're doing great.
Oh my God.
You gotta keep going?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you know what you need to do again. Let's go back down again. One. Be there now. Mother Mary,
Yes.
Tell me what happened with Melis just now.
She remembered.
She remembered. Mm-hmm. What does she remember?
When she's laying down on the floor.
Mm-hmm. And what did that cause her?
Pain.
Mm-hmm. Did she need to get that pain out physically?
Yes.
Okay. Did that help?
Mm-hmm.
To vomit all of that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Were there emotions in there?
Yes.
Okay, so we were able to get all of that out of her. Good. What else would you like to tell Nellie's today?
I am with you. I protect you.
Mm-hmm. Mother Mary, I know that she had a bit of a brain injury. Are you able to help heal that brain to where she doesn't have that fog or lack of concentration?
Yes.
Okay, would you do that for her? Put your hands over her head. Have her feel that. Have her feel your hands on there. Allow her to transmit all of that energy through her hands into her head. And tell her what it is that is going on. It is okay. Wonderful. Thank you very much. Is there anything that Nellis would like to tell Mother Mary?
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for being with me, for protecting me.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you, Mother Mary, for all of that. Let me speak again with the higher self. Would you do a scan of her brain and tell me how it looks now? Good, very good. Would you look at all her chakras and see if all her chakras are balanced and open? Her heart chakra. Mm-hmm. What's going on with that?
I need to be open.
Okay, would you open that for her now?
Yeah.
Thank you. Is there anything that she can do to also help?
Trust.
Okay, trust. Let her know how you're opening her chakras. Are you using any particular light?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What color?
Green.
Green, okay. Why are you using green? For the heart chakra?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Would you tell me why that chakra was closed?
She doesn't feel love.
She doesn't feel love from her mother?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What about now, after we've done that forgiveness?
She'll be okay.
Okay, good. Let me know when you're done with that chakra.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. What about any other chakras? She asked particularly about the third eye chakra.
It's open.
It's open. Mm-hmm. How open is it?
We're working on.
Mm-hmm.
She's not ready to see all.
She's not ready to see all of it?
No.
Tell her why.
her life will change.
Mm-hmm.
But she has high frequency and energy.
Mm-hmm. Is that helping or hurting?
We are working with her body.
Mm-hmm.
We are making her strong.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. What about the throat? When she, before she started her session, she said she had a pressure there, as if something was trying to come out.
We want to communicate.
Okay. And you're communicating now?
Yes.
So what was the pressure? Is that a sign that you use for her, that you want to communicate?
Yes.
Okay. I'm a little confused about that because you brought her to the session for communicating. Why would you need a sign like that?
Because she's not ready to hear.
Okay. Is there anything that you wanted to tell her that she didn't ask about?
She's on a journey.
She's on a journey?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Tell me about that journey.
She's been choosing.
She didn't choose it?
She's been chosen.
Okay.
By us.
You were chosen. She was chosen by you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And who are you?
We are the masters.
The masters. Okay. Can you tell me about that?
We're here.
Mm-hmm.
To prepare the people for what is coming.
Okay. I'm very interested in hearing that, and I'm sure that others want to heal, to hear about this. Would you tell me about what the plan is for the new earth?
We have to come together. As one family.
As one family?
Yeah.
How can we do that?
By love.
Mm-hmm.
By giving love to others.
Giving love to others, okay.
Like Nellis does.
Like Nellis does, okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And how many people need to be giving this love for the new earth?
Many. And every day more and more are becoming awakened.
More and more becoming awakened?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's causing them to become awakened? Is there something happening in the atmosphere that makes them wake up?
The song.
The song?
Yeah.
What song is that?
The song.
Oh, the sun.
Yeah.
Oh, what's happening with the sun?
Energy.
Mm-hmm. Is it changing?
Is the energy is stronger.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Now, when you say that the energy is stronger, does that mean that it's going to be hotter? Or just the energy is different?
Just the energy is different.
Okay. And what is it that we... what do we get from the sun besides heat?
Life. Life.
That's our life force?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more about that so I can understand.
You will be fed by the air, by the sun.
We will be fed by the air, by the sun?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We don't need food?
We won't need it.
Okay. Is that how life will be on the new earth?
Yeah.
We just will feed off of the air?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else? Will we need water?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
in this new earth is the same one that we are on now.
Yes, okay. But it would come in a split.
It will be split?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. How will that happen?
Many awakening.
Mm-hmm. Many will be awakened?
Mm-hmm.
Will we notice anything different about the earth once it splits?
No.
No?
It's going to be.
Mm-hmm.
Just extraordinary.
Extraordinary. Is there an event that's going to happen?
2019. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So 3 years from now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now you were talking about us feeding off of the sun. Nellie's was telling me that her diet has been changing. That she doesn't want anything to do with meat. She only wants raw vegetables and fruits.
Yeah.
Tell me about that. How does the awakening change your diet?
Your life, your body has to be light.
Mm-hmm.
To be prepared for the high frequency energy.
Mm-hmm.
And dimensions.
The high frequency and the dimensions?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So how do we get the body to be light?
No eat meat.
No meat? Mm-hmm. Of no. Any kind?
No meat.
Mm-hmm. What about fish?
That's what she's eating.
That's what she's eating? Mm-hmm.
Eventually she's gonna get sick.
Eventually she's gonna get sick? So she won't be able to eat fish anymore?
No.
Okay. Just vegetables and water and fruit?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We make her sick.
Okay, so you're doing that so she doesn't eat that.
Yeah.
What about the rest of the population that wants to be awakened and wants to be on the new earth? What do they need to do?
They need to wash the water. The water is poison.
The water is poison?
Yeah.
How do we fix that? How do we drink better water?
Alkaline water.
Alkaline water, okay.
Yeah.
Do we need to process it?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Will that help with the pineal gland also?
Yeah, that's why she's opening.
That's why she's opening? She's drinking alkaline water?
Yeah.
Okay. What message do you have for the rest of humanity about the new earth and about changes?
It's going to be better for everybody.
There's going to be what for everybody?
Better. Better life.
A better life, okay, for everybody.
It's not going to be no more slaving.
No more slaving?
No.
Mm-hmm.
No need to work.
No need to work?
No.
How will we function on the new earth?
You will know when it's come.
We will know when it's coming?
Mm-hmm.
It'll be different than we...
Yeah.
Now? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Will we have the same bodies as we have now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Human body.
Human bodies?
It's powerful.
Very powerful. Okay. Are we going to take these bodies with us to the new earth?
Yes, but mm-hmm. light.
But light. Mm-hmm. So we need to prepare them?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are you the masters helping everybody with this preparation?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not the only one.
You're not the only one. Who else is helping?
We are many.
How many are you?
8.
8?
8 masters.
8 masters. So how can 8 of you take care of billions of people? How is that possible?
We choose people.
Oh, okay. You choose different people?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How many have you chosen so far?
Many. Many. Every day more and more.
Mm-hmm. And what responsibility do these people have once they're awakened? What should they be doing?
Awaken the furthest brother.
Awaken the furthest brother?
The brothers.
Their brothers, okay.
Yeah.
The fellow brothers,
the
okay.
Fellow brothers.
Okay, so when they awaken, they should be awakening those around them.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's what they should be doing.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And how is Nellie's going to be awakening others?
She will lead.
She will lead.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Can you give her a hint of how she should be doing this?
Nellie's have a way to talk to people.
Mm-hmm.
She will talk.
She will talk to them?
Mm-hmm. Is she supposed to do this one by one or in groups?
Groups.
Groups. Okay. Good. And you had told us before that she was going to use premonitions.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, as masters, what roles do you have in her life? What do you do for her?
We just prepare her.
You prepare her? Do you do this while she's awake or she's asleep?
Sleeping.
Mm-hmm. And are you the ones responsible for the tremors in her body?
Yes.
Okay. Will they continue? Or can you tone those down?
She will not. How to use her power.
She will learn how to use her power.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So the tremors won't be needed later?
No.
Okay. How much longer is she going to receive these tremors?
Maybe a year.
A year? Okay. Mm-hmm. Good. Do you have a message for the rest of the world about the awakening that you would like to tell them?
We have to come once.
They have to come once?
Together.
Together?
Mm-hmm. To make it happen.
To make it happen. So all of them need to get together to make it happen.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
This is going to be a better one. Better.
It's going to be a better world.
For everybody.
Mm-hmm.
We are living in fears.
We're living in fears?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How can we stop the fear?
By trusting in God.
By trusting in God.
Mm-hmm. Is there any way that I can help awaken others?
You're already helping.
Mm-hmm.
You're doing a good job.
Thank you. How can I do better?
People need to know you more. You have to become more public.
Become more public?
Mm-hmm.
And put these sessions out more?
Yes.
Are they awakening the masses?
It's helping.
It's helping. Good. That's what I want to do.
You're helping.
Is anybody who is watching this, how can they help accelerate this? You said that they can awaken others, but how else can they do it?
People will become very conscious.
Mm-hmm. People will become very conscious.
Yes.
Okay.
And things are going to change rapidly.
Things will change rapidly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Good.
You're going to be very busy.
Who's going to be very busy?
You.
Me. Busier than I am now.
Yes.
Oh boy.
Yes.
Who's helping me?
You have your angels. Michael is your angel.
Mm-hmm.
He's always with you. You are very strong. You have a connection with him.
I have a connection with Michael.
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna work together?
Yes.
Okay.
Also, Gabriel.
Gabriel?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What does he do for me?
He's going to help you to heal with the healing process.
With the healing process?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Does he help me with the forgiveness?
Too.
Mm-hmm.
That is part of the process.
That's part of the process.
People get sick.
Mm-hmm.
Because they live in fear and they don't forgive.
Mm-hmm. So Gabriel's the one who helps me with the journey of forgiveness?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Thank you, Gabriel.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful. So we need to continue this work.
Yeah.
Good. Very good. Anything else that you would like to tell me? Or Nellie's today, Masters?
No, thank you for having her here.
And thank you for bringing her here. I appreciate it very much. Are we complete today?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
I'm exhausted.
You're exhausted?
Yeah.
What do you remember?
Not much.
Not much? Were you gone most of the time?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel besides exhausted?
Tired.
Tired?
But very peaceful.
Very peaceful. Wonderful.
I only know the master were here.
The masters were here. Yeah, they were. They had a lot of things to say. Do you remember anything that they said?
Only about what's going to happen with the earth.
Uh-huh, the new earth.
Mm-hmm.
How long do you think we were on this journey together?
How long, I'm sorry?
Yeah, how long did it feel?
Thirty minutes?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I have 2 hours and 11 minutes.
Wow. I started drunk.
You feel drunk?
Yes. Yes. And I don't drink.
And you don't drink?
Yeah.
What do you think about this experience?
It's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
You have a mission too.
Mm-hmm.
You have.
What else did you get from it?
A lot of information.
Mm-hmm.
That I was looking for.
Mm-hmm.
Also that I know that I'm not alone, there are people like you,
mm-hmm.
that's going to help others to be awake.
Yeah.
So,
it's an important job.
Yes, we have a journey.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They said that I was going to be very busy too.
Yes. Yes. You were. Very busy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, do you recommend this to other people?
Absolutely.
How does your stomach feel now, your neck?
Much better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got everything out that you needed to.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What an experience.
I know.
Well, you needed to purge all of that.
I know. I feel like I was in an ayahuasca place and I never been in one. Yes.
We had an imaginary ayahuasca ceremony.
Oh my God, it was bad.
Wow. So do you want to share this experience? Yes, absolutely. Edit out any part that is personal.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But the masters were definitely an experience in your past life. Do you remember any of that?
Yes, a little. Only when I was in Europe.
Mm-hmm.
With the streets and the house.
Yeah.
I remember the stair, they come together like this.
Yeah, beautiful staircase.
Yes.
The chandelier.
And chandelier, crystal in the mirror.
Wow.
I see her. I remember her. I don't see much of the face of my mother.
Mm-hmm.
But I know she was white and tall lady. She was sitting having her tea with her friend. Fancy.
Fancy, very fancy.
Very fancy.
Very British.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Very
good.
Yeah.
All right, let me disconnect you. The tremors have stopped for now.
Oh, good.
The what?
Vomiting and terror.
The vomiting was pretty bad, huh? Well, I was prepared, though.
Yes, I saw you then. Okay,
I follow my guides too.
Yes.
When they tell me go get a bucket, I get a bucket.
Oh my God.
How do you know? I've been doing this for a while.
Yes, so
when my guides tell me get the bucket, she's gonna throw up.
Wow.
Twice or more. I think you were
like
you were throwing up a bit. Okay, so let me say goodbye here. I'm Alba Weinman. We're here in Miami, Florida. We just had an extraordinary session with a lot of crazy stuff. If you would like to have your own hypnosis session, please visit my website, albaweinman.com, and I look forward to seeing you again. Thank you.